What's up, everybody? JJ Shankles, the Goat Toasters here, and Nikon has finally done it. They've created official software for using your Nikon natively as a webcam on your computer. Finally, Nikon has caught up with the time. So many other camera manufacturers have done this. Canon, Sony, they've already gotten this. Previously, Nikon's only stance was, hey, you should use other software to do this or capture cards. That doesn't make sense. This is a way better solution. I'm going to take you through the steps and show you how easy it is to get it set up. So this is the website you go to. I'll put a link in the description down below. And you go down here, it talks you through the installation. So you just select your region, select download. So when you select download, it'll pop up and ask where you want to download it. So you can create a new folder. I just created a new folder on the desktop. Name it Nikon Webcam. Enter that folder, just download it there, select save, wait for it to download, click that, and it'll just run. This is the window that pops up. Accept the license and terms and agreement. I did actually glance through this, and it basically just says you can't sell this software to other people. Makes sense. I'm not going to be selling this software. Only going to be downloading it and using it. That's what this software is intended for. That's what that license kind of covers. Say finish. And that's it. It doesn't look like it's done anything. It's more of a driver that you're downloading onto your computer, if that makes sense. We're going to test this out on OBS. OBS is what I use for recording my monitor or screen capture or for streaming online. But if you're using for Zoom calls or Skype calls, whatever you're using it for, it'll be a similar setup. So then we got our camera here. This is the D850. I'm recording on the Z6 right now, but we're going to use this one as our test camera. This camera uses micro USB, so you're going to need a compatible USB cable. Plug it into my computer over here, plug this into the camera. So when you plug in your camera, you're going to go in and select Nikon Webcam Utility as the camera device. It'll be the same if you're using Zoom or Skype or whatever video conferencing system, and then it'll start working. Manual focus on this one, so. Yeah, now it's working. Super easy to use. And that's about all there is to it to get it up and running with your Nikon camera. This won't work with every Nikon camera. It's only more modern Nikon cameras, specifically the Z6, Z7, Z5, Z50, the D6, the D850, the D780, D500, D7500, the D5600. But if you have one of those cameras, it makes it really easy to set up your Nikon camera as a webcam. A few tips and tricks I did find. If your camera has a tilt out screen, if you tilt the screen out like this, it helps your camera not worry about overheating at all. I didn't get that much overheating. I did a test with the Nikon Z6, had it streaming as a webcam for about an hour. And if you touch the back screen, you could feel a little warmth. But if you tilt the screen out like this, then you're not gonna have any problems with overheating. It's not a Canon or Sony, so you really don't have to worry about overheating here. A lot of Nikon lenses are better photography lenses than video lenses. So if you're recording with a microphone nearby, you might not want to leave auto, because with auto, it'll be constantly doing that. It puts this little, these chirps of the autofocus trying to refocus and refocus. So it's not the best for that. The other thing to think about if you're going to be streaming for a long period of time is battery life. The battery life on these cameras aren't going to keep going for hours on end. So you might need to get a third-party solution like this. This is a dummy battery. I'll put a link to the Amazon link down below, but this is just a dummy battery. Then it goes down to a DC barrel plug, and that you plug into, there's an adapter that goes into the wall. I can't find the adapter right now, but it's around here somewhere. And so that will just take the place of your Nikon battery in the camera. It works great. I've used it as a webcam for doing time lapses before, and the battery just works all day long. Super easy to work with. But that about wraps it up. Super easy tutorial today. Let me know in the comments down below if you have any questions. And if you found this tutorial helpful, give me that thumbs up and that subscribe. It really helps this channel out, and it means so much to me personally. Thank you guys so much for sticking around, and I'll see you on the next video. Go Toaster out.